What is going on, YouTube fan? It's your boy Tony Two Times, and we back with another episode of the Baltimore Way, man. I appreciate the love and support, like always. Be sure to like, comment, share the videos, man. All the supporters, man, it's all love, man. Anybody got something negative to say, man? It is what it is, man. I love y'all too. Let's get into it, man. So this is a requested video. Somebody sent me an email, bro, from Montgomery County, Maryland, and he wanted to know why everybody he meet from Baltimore got war wounds. Basically, why the crime rate so high, why so much violence. So it go deep, y'all, you feel me? It go way deeper than we possibly think, you know what I mean? We can always talk about the streets and talk about what go on in the streets, the drug trade, the beef, the gangs. But when I was reading something, we had a lot of corruption. It's always been a lot of corruption. Some of the mayors did different things with money. Prime example, it supposed to have been a few million dollars for the bus line. You feel me? Y'all remember we had MTA. I don't even know what it's called now. I think it's called Link, Maryland Link. So a lot of people in Baltimore don't got cars. So they don't got a lot of jobs either in the city. A lot of the jobs in like White Marsh, you feel me, Randallstown, like in the suburbs. So people can't get to work. The bus is all messed up, stuff like that. Okay, let's move that excuse to the side, because you know people gonna say that's an excuse you can make it to work. Now let's talk about the percentage of parents that's addicted to narcotics. You feel me? I was a victim of that. Rest in peace, my mother. I love her to death. Ain't got nothing bad to say about her. But you know, when I was born and I came into this world, she was fighting addiction. You know what I mean? So you coming out, one or two parents addicted to something, or one parent locked up, one parent addicted to something. So you already behind the eight ball. Now you growing up in this environment where you ain't seeing nobody really going to work like that, because they really either ain't got no way to work, or they just give up and be like, man, I'm gonna hit the block. Cause as soon as you step out your front door, it's money to be made. You know what I mean? Like I said, everybody doing substance abuse. So if you the person that got it, you gonna make the money. So it give you an easy way out. Now you born into this situation. Now you peeping your environment. You seeing what's going on around you. It forces you to be a wolf or a sheep. Either you gonna get with it or you gonna get ate. So now, even if you don't wanna be that way, you forced to be a predator. You forced to prey on people, try to find a way to feed your family. I tell people, don't judge unless you've been in that situation. You can't judge nobody till you put yourself in their shoes. You don't know what you'll do if your kid's hungry at night, or if you hungry at night, the lights out, the rent need to be paid. You know what I mean? That bring the worst out of people. And so the reason I feel like a lot of people get hit up, you feel me, the crime rate so high, is lack of opportunities, you know what I mean? Corruption. Police doing crooked things, you see what I'm saying? The gang rigged, like I said yesterday. You got the police out there hustling right beside you. That's real crazy. So man, when you put in that kind of environment, things happen because everybody hungry. It's like throwing hyenas in a pack of meat, you feel me? Like, you throw the food out there, everybody hungry, they gonna go eat. And in the meanwhile, somebody might get hurt. That's just how it go. It's sad, you feel me? It's real sad, it's messed up. It shouldn't be like that, because people gotta start thinking outside the box and try to think past the trap, because that's all it is a trap. Even what we call hustling nowadays, people call it the trap. It's a trap, you see what I'm saying? It's set up for you to feel like it ain't no other way out. Like all you could do is the things that's in front of you. If you grow up watching people bagging up at 5 years old, you coming outside, you seeing people nodding. You come in the house, you see your parents nodding out. You go look in the refrigerator, ain't nothing to eat. Your mindset at a young age is already adapting to all this. So you growing up with a vendetta already. You going to schools. Oh yeah, by the way, the money that supposed to be put into Maryland schools a few years ago went into building a brand new juvenile facility. Things like that, you see what I'm saying? So the thing about the South that's different that they put it in your face. They let you know, like, we don't really rock with y'all like that. It is what it is. But up north, it's a little more discreet. They try to hide it. They do things they think we ain't gonna find out about. Like, prime example, John Hopkins almost bought the whole East Baltimore. That put a lot of people out of homes. All around Ashland, all around Rose, all around, all over East, all down the hill. They almost own all that. I'm surprised Monument Street still right there. But that put people in a situation where they breaking up families. They gotta move, some people gotta move to the suburbs. Some people gotta move on this side of town, that side of town. Now you going around people you don't know. You getting used to a whole new environment. And what you've been taught all your life is to go out there, get money, make something happen. But now you in somebody else's hood trying to get money. So yeah, you gonna have war wounds. Things gonna happen. And you know Montgomery County, that's one of the richest counties in Maryland. So at first I ain't really understand his question, cause in my mind, I'm like, this happens in every inner city. But I get where he coming from. He like, why so many people getting hurt? Why so many people, you feel me, acting like it's normal to have wounds all over their body? You know what I mean? But it's just a mindset, and not even a mindset, it's survival of the fittest. Man, it took me a long time, and I'm still practicing this, to break that mindset. You know, to look at everybody like brothers and sisters. You know what I mean? And that come with a price too. Because it's still gonna be people out here that's gonna try you. And when you come from an environment, when somebody try you, you won't go. That's all you know. It take a lot of restraint not to be like that. You know what I mean? So yeah, it's really set up like that. You feel me? And for the kids out there, man, you just gotta, what I can, only thing I can tell y'all, tap into something young. Tap into what you wanna do young. Don't worry about what's going on around you. You know what I mean? With this internet, you can really escape your reality. If you like computers, look at computer videos all day on YouTube. If you like music, see how they doing this. See how they shooting a video. Seeing how they producing it. Seeing how dude writing 16s. So it's ways to get around that now. But yeah, man, it's just, you know, a little quick video, man. I could go all night about this subject. And it's a lot of other things I want to touch on. You feel me? About the city and why it's the way it is. You know what I mean? But I'm gonna get into that in another video, you feel me? But to answer bro question, like I said, man, I just think it's a mindset, lack of opportunities, and some people born into it. You feel me? You don't wanna be out there. You don't wanna go through that, but that's your reality. So never judge somebody till you walk in their shoes. It's another episode of the Baltimore Way. Love y'all, fam. I'm out.